This is the Artemis 1, NASA's first mission to use the new Space Launch System Rocket, or SLS for short. It was designed as a replacement for the retired space shuttle, and it's the largest and most powerful rocket in the world. It's taller than the Statue of Liberty, even at its shortest configuration, towering to a height of 322 feet. It weighs 5.75 million pounds when fully fueled, and can generate 8.8 million pounds of thrust. NASA says that's about as much power as 160,000 Corvette engines. That sure is a lot of power, and the SLS needs it. Because if the new rocket system's first mission is successful, it could be the key to taking humanity back to the moon and beyond. But the SLS is more than just a rocket. As the name implies, this is a space launch system, a platform that can be customized and reconfigured depending on the mission. The result is an incredibly enormous rocket, one that's incredibly hard to move. In fact, moving it from NASA's vehicle assembly building to the launch pad is an incredible feat of engineering, requiring the use of a massive crawler transporter. It can take between 6 and 12 hours to complete the 4-mile journey. It'll still be weeks before it's ready for liftoff, but even then, we'll still be a ways off from stepping foot on the surface of the moon. In fact, there won't even be any astronauts flying on Artemis 1. This mission is an unmanned flight designed to test the spacecraft's systems. Once it reaches the moon, the Orion spacecraft will stay in orbit for about 6 days before using the moon's gravity to slingshot itself back to Earth. It's not as exciting as landing a new crew on the moon itself, but that's the eventual goal. If Artemis 1 is successful, Artemis 2 will bring us even closer by having a crewed mission loop around the moon and back again. And for Artemis 3, NASA plans to have 2 astronauts touch down on the surface for the first time in 50 years. NASA also plans for the Artemis to put the first woman and first person of color on the moon. That's worthwhile in its own right, but simply walking on the moon isn't the Artemis mission's only goal. NASA hopes that it'll inspire a new generation to reignite America's passion for space discovery. And perhaps, most importantly, hopes that what we learn by establishing a long-term presence on the moon will help us plan our next big mission in space, sending a human to Mars. NASA hopes to accomplish these goals within a decade, but we may have to be patient. The SLS rocket itself has been in the works for over a decade and was originally slated for launch in 2016. We're definitely trying to go back to the moon, and eventually Mars, but it may take a while. So until then, we're looking to the stars.